Let's start off with, okay, the one thing that everybody wants to know, how much snow is going to fall out of this thing. Here's our early estimates of what's going to happen. And I feel pretty comfortable with these. I'm going to show you some computer models in a few moments, and you'll be able to see why I'm kind of believing that these numbers are looking pretty good. Obviously, more snow inland, lesser amounts at the coast because we get the mixing going on. This is what I call a classic New England snowstorm, because this is what happens so many times. If you're down through the South Shore, the Cape and the Islands, you're going, what snow? Meanwhile, Worcester's digging out from a foot of snow. So there's a big spread many times between it. Has a lot to do with our elevation. So here's the storm coming in. And as I mentioned, nothing really going on until Saturday night. So this is the map at Saturday night at 10 o'clock. Now, there may be some stray snow showers ahead of it. There's going to be a lot of gray skies out there on Saturday afternoon. But Saturday morning may actually start with a little hint of sunshine. And then it really starts to move in here. And you can see what happens. Now, look carefully. And you see that magenta color right there? That's the mix. And it's right there at the coast down through the Cape. As the system goes by, it will then pull into some colder air. And it'll drive the snow down toward the Cape. Which means at the Cape, you may not get your snow until probably after everyone else is talking about, well, the snow is really piling up here. By about 2, 3 o'clock, you should be changing over. And, you know, there's going to be a lot of rain with this thing. And I'll show you in a moment that we're looking at maybe an inch to an inch and a half of liquid content. That's a lot of water. And what happens is when the storm starts to pull that colder air in, we're going to start to freeze some things up. Not a flash freeze. I'm not worried about that. But it will be cold enough that there may be some ice in areas that really had rain for most of this entire event. So then the whole thing pulls out of here. By midnight, it's pretty much gone, and we're pretty much done with it. And this is why we're kind of talking about this storm more than we normally would. I mean, it's not a huge storm. It's a good-sized one, but it's not huge. But the reason is we haven't gotten any snow. I mean, Boston, we picked up 2/10. That was that first week in December. You know, down towards Rockland, there was about 3 inches of snow that fell out of that one. Worcester picking up some snow. Most of Worcester was actually in November. So we're running a good foot to a foot and a half below where we're supposed to be this time of year. And we didn't really have much of a winter last year. So the National Weather Service issued a winter storm watch this afternoon, but it does not go into effect until Saturday at 4 o'clock. And then it goes until late Sunday night. Now, at 4 o'clock, it's not going to get all started, but that just gives you a little heads up that that's going to be going on as we head towards Saturday evening. Now, the area that is not in this watch is down to the south. That's because we're going to deal with some mix in the Brockton and New Bedford area. You get on the other side of the canal, we're going to deal with rain. Eventually, it will change over to all snow, and we will get a little accumulation out of it. But it's really the inland areas that are going to be seeing most of the snow from this one. And the thing we need is cold air. We have had so many storms this winter where we got tons and tons of rain. Remember, we've had places that have got 3 and 4 inches of rain out of the whole thing. Imagine that with some cold weather. We'd be talking about 3, 4 feet of snow. We've had plenty of moisture. We just haven't had the cold. So this time around, we are going to get some cold coming in here. And it's coming in tonight. So a heads up, your Friday is going to be cold and windy. Cold air is in place. Now we just wait for the storm to catch up with us. And that's going to eventually get in here. So that's what we'll be watching as we go forward into this storm. So that's the cold air. And you can see where it's coming from. Look at Canada. Never been to Moosonee, but it's only 5 right now. Churchill, 17 below. And some of these towns I can't even pronounce because they got so many vowels in them. But it is cold up there, and we're just going to tap into that. And the tapped-in cold air will be with us on Friday, Saturday, and on Sunday. And that's why we're talking about snow instead of rain like we have done so many times before. So we've made this an impact weather day. Impact weather means that, hey, there's something you really need to pay attention to. Sometimes we'll do a nuisance where we put a yellow light up, and that just means kind of like, oh, it's going to be an inconvenience for you. We put the red up, it's like, eh, you need to pay attention to this one because there's going to be a lot of things going on. And of course, the one thing that's really going to be going on with this storm is the fact that it's snow and slick roads. And we have not been on slick roads for a while. We didn't get much of a winter last year. Rain and mix near the coast, but as I pointed out, at the end of the storm, it gets cold. Got to watch out. There could be some icy spots with it. And then gusts of 40 to 50 miles an hour at the coast, especially as you look down toward the Cape. You know, one thing I talk about driving in the snow, I did a story a few weeks ago about electric vehicles. And there is something you need to do. If you have an electric vehicle, there's a snow button on there. And the reason you push that snow button is because the car has what's called regenerative braking. In other words, as the car slows down, it sort of grabs and regenerates electricity and feeds it back into the batteries. It's a great system that works. However, in the winter, when it's icy, that regenerative braking could actually put you into a slide more than you wanted to. So that's why they put that snow button on there. So push the snow button if you have an electric vehicle and be prepared for that. That's the reason they put that there is because of that regenerative braking that goes on. It's a really interesting story. I was with Lars Anderson Auto Museum. If you have a chance to stop over, it's a great place to hang out and see some really amazing vehicles. And they were very, very helpful with that story. All right, snowfall totals. This is what we're looking at. As I mentioned, lesser amount toward the Cape, more as you look inland, and especially as you get to the Worcester Hills and some elevation, 9 to 12 inches. Now, I don't think everybody west of Worcester is going to get 12 inches of snow. But if you get elevation, say 1,500 feet and above, you know the places. They're going to pick up a lot more snow than it is if you're down in the valleys just a little bit. So that's the general trend that we're looking at for snowfall. And people wonder, okay, what kind of snow am I going to shovel? Inland, it's fluffier because it's colder. So that's why the snow will pile up more. You get closer to the coast, it gets wetter. And by the time you get down toward the south shore of the Cape, it's basically a 7-Eleven Slurpee. You know, I mean, the snowblowers don't even move it very well. So you may end up having to dig out the shovel. Many people are, we had a great story on last night from John Atwater, and he was putting together a story about what you need to do with your snowblower if you haven't used it in a couple of years, which is what a lot of people are having to deal with because they have not used it for a while. So it was an interesting story. I hope you had a chance to do it. If not, you can check it out on our website. We still have it up there, I'm sure. So, all right, that's what we're dealing with. Now, I have been dealing with the, with the computer models all week. And a lot of people like these things, and you see them all over the web. Everybody's got them. Social media is full of, you know, the European model, the U.S. model, all of these things. And so I try to give you some insight as to what these models are saying and how they behave and how they play into our forecast and how we use them as meteorologists. They're guidance. They're not really forecasts. We call them guidance because it's kind of the raw numbers being kicked out by the computer, and it gives us an idea of what is happening. And then I watch for trends. You know, is it being consistent, model run after model run after model run, or is it consistent with other models so that everybody's kind of in agreement? So this is the latest model run that we had come in just this afternoon, and you'll see there was a great deal of consistency between these. The European, which is usually my favorite one, was a little bit kind of flopping all over the place initially on this one. And the GFS US model has kind of brought up its totals a little bit and then bracked them off a little bit. So you see the trend here. It's going to be, you know, lesser amounts of snow down toward the Cape, more snow inland. They have backed off a little bit, but I think that the issue that these two models have had for this entire event going into it, they've really had a difficult time realizing that the ocean is as warm as it is. It's on fire. I mean, you know, we talk about climate change and we've talked about it a bunch here on News Center 5. But the thing about it is that with climate change and that ocean being so warm, that warm air coming in is the reason we're going to see some mixing. And the computer model is having a little difficult time with it. And so that's why you'll see I have quite a range in snowfall totals. Now, if the wind changes direction or the storm tracks a little bit different, that's going to be a big hindrance. Remember, this far out, if we get the storm to track within 150 miles of where we think it is, that's pretty much considered a success. So a little jog this way, a little jog that way, and it can change it dramatically as to what's going to happen with the storm. So that is one thing I'll be really, really watching as the storm goes through, what the track is. I mean, if it cuts over the Cape, well, a lot of us will have rain. If it goes offshore, that's when we get all the snow. And then somewhere in between is when we get all that mix coming through here. So the liquid content, which I think is fascinating, if you look at how much moisture is available for the storm, it's an inch to an inch and a half. So that means if this was just pure cold and we had all this moisture coming in, we'd be talking about a good foot and a half of snow out of the whole thing. But because we're doing so much mixing going on with it, that's going to hold the totals down. And you can see where the heaviest rain is going to be, or liquid content, is going to be down toward the Cape. But there again, you're going to be able to deal with more mixing than you are, say, west of Worcester and out towards Orange. So at Orange, we're going to squeeze all the moisture out and make it into snow. But maybe towards Hyannis, it's going to be taking a little bit more time before we can get the snow down there. And so a lot of it's going to be falling as rain. But let me give you an hour-by-hour breakdown of what's going to happen. This is Saturday night at 9 o'clock. You have plans on Saturday? You're fine. Morning, you might even see a little sunshine. Afternoon, you get some clouds. Sun goes down. Okay, now we're going to pay attention because this is the snow moving in. And again, remember, we're talking about this on Thursday night, and this isn't even going to happen until late Saturday night. So a lot of things can change. So that's why I say stay on top of the forecast. And if I can, for just a moment, tell you about apps. You know, you get an app on your phone. You probably have a weather app you're looking at, and it puts a big snowflake up there. But it doesn't tell you the time. It doesn't tell you the intensity. It doesn't tell you what all the variables are. And so that's why I say the app is good, but you really need to go ahead and go to a couple other sources and find out what's going on. And for those of you who watch us on Channel 5, we're very happy. Storm Team has got a great group of people, and we've been able to put some forecasts together. I think they've been very, very good. We've had some great predecessors. You know, we had Dick Albert, Harvey Leonard. We've really tapped into that vast amount of knowledge that they've given us over the years. And it's really just something you cannot get from just going to school and learning about weather. I mean, you'd be around somebody like that for a while and you just can't help but absorb stuff that's going on. But anyhow, back to what this timeline and the snow is coming through. So here it is, 9 o'clock at night. you know, at the coast, it's still marginal. I don't even know if you'd hold snow under those temperatures. And then we kind of push the snow in here after midnight is when the steadiest comes in. The darker blue colors that you see down there by Bridgeport, that's the heavy snow. That's the intense stuff. The pink magenta color that you see, that's the mix. And then, of course, the green is rain. So as we go deeper into the night and closer to tomorrow morning, Sunday morning. We go towards Sunday morning. You'll see that how we get that mix going on through the South Shore, the Cape, and the islands. Inland, the snow is getting very intense at this point. Look at orange at 29. You really have no chance of getting any rain out of this thing. It's going to be all snow. But you get to Boston southward, 35, you can get snow, but more likely it's going to be mixing at that point. And then as the day goes on, late morning, see how that cold air is being drawn down through Plymouth? That's why it'll change over to snow. If you're in Hyannis, still 40 degrees. It's just going to be kind of a mix in the air, and a lot of it melting on contact. But then as we get into the afternoon, see how the cold air kind of sinks farther and farther south? And that tells us then, oh, we're going to start to change some of that mix over to some snow. And that's when you may get your accumulation. You may not get it over the Cape until very late into the storm. Now, because it's coming in so late, we're running out of moisture. So by 8 o'clock, we're down to kind of a light snow, but it's light snow everywhere. This is where I'd be concerned about ice from Plymouth southward, because now we have the cold air coming in. You can get some roads icy. And, of course, it's been raining all day, so the crews haven't put much for chemicals and salt out. So they're a little bit behind at that point. So you've got to give them a little time to get that stuff out there. I would say Sunday, you know, just kind of plan on staying home. You know, there's really no reason to go out in this stuff. Unless, of course, you got a good sled. Then I would take it out. But anyhow, we head for Sunday about 11 o'clock. This thing is all over with. But here comes the cold weather, and it is going to be a cold start to the week. As we start things off, it looks like probably wind chills again back down to the single digits on Monday morning. So a chilly, chilly start to your Monday morning out there. So snow forecast, as I said, heavier amounts out toward the west, 9 to 12 inches of snow seems very likely at this point. But not everyone's going to see 12 inches, but you get about 1,500 feet, I think there'll be a foot out there in some places. And there's always one or two spots that overachieves and gets even more than that. Then you head down toward the Cape, you won't get that till late in the storm. I would say for Boston right now, if you look at it, I would say, you know, kind of at like Logan Airport, Winthrop, you're probably in that 1 to 3 category. But then you get kind of downtown out to 128, kind of that 3 to 6 category. And everybody always looks at the high number. Look at the low number sometimes, because that may be a little closer to what's going on with the storm. And then once you get to 128 out to 495, 6 to 9 category seems like. And then once you get to 495, we're going to be seeing more out there. It's interesting. You know, people ask me, why do you use those roads? Why are the roads kind of like the delineation for where the snow falls? Because 128 is built on the first elevation rise. 495 is built along the next elevation rise. So as you go from the coast to 128 to 495, that elevation really plays into a forecast. We're so grateful that the engineers 100 years ago decided to build those roads so we could use them for forecasting in that way, but no, I'm just kidding. But that's the reason we use those, and they work out really well. It's because of the elevation changes that take place there. So that helps with snowfall totals. That's why I was saying, you know, if you're above 1,500 feet, you're probably going to see more snow than somebody is in the valley. Same thing out towards Cape Ann, Gloucester, Rockport, you're probably that 1 to 3 category, but over towards North Reading, maybe 3 to 6. Get over towards Lowell, 6 to 9. And then, you know, once you get past Groton, you're talking about even more snow out there. Down toward the Cape, as I say, it's, you know, a lot of rain. There's plenty of moisture, but I don't know the cold's going to get there until late in the storm. So that's why I'm saying about 1 to 3. In Nantucket, you're pretty much stuck in the rain all the way through. The ocean surrounding you is about 45 degrees at this point down around Nantucket. And then west of Worcester, 6 to 12 inches of snow. You know the usual spots. I mean, you get up there towards Leominster and Fitchburg and Orange around Route 2. Those are the areas that are most likely to get a foot of snow. And then lesser amounts as you look down toward the valleys. And in Worcester, of course, you have so many hills and stuff. You can get high totals in one part of town and low totals in the other part of town just because of the up and downs that are going through there. So that's how much snow we're thinking about as it comes on through. Again, not a blockbuster storm, but probably one of the heavier snows we've seen. Heavier than we saw last year in most cases. And some places, this is the heaviest snow you've seen in 2 years. Wow. Climate change is really impacting our snow around the area, isn't it? That's a topic for another day. All right. The winds, they're going to really ramp up out of this thing. And they're going to be coming out of the northeast. Typically, you know, you get worried about a nor'easter with the tides and things like that. I'm not overly concerned just because the time this is coming in and when those winds really ramp up. But over the Cape, 40, 50 mile an hour wind gusts seem very, very likely. Interesting today. We're actually on an anniversary. I'm going to talk about that in a second, but let me talk about a little bit about what's going to happen Sunday morning. That's our highest high tide. It's at 719, but you see things haven't really ramped up at that point. And by the time we get to Sunday evening high tide, the wind has switched direction, kind of to the northwest. So really the biggest surge that's going to happen from this storm is going to happen probably around lunchtime on Sunday. So unless the storm slows down or speeds up, it's not coming in at the right time to really get a lot of flooding going on, which I think is really welcome.